Hey guys, welcome back to another part of my series on the Magic Lantern using my Canon 6D camera. I'm going to be covering a new section today. Hopefully you've watched or you enjoyed the last one I did on the exposure. And today we're going to be covering overlays. I tried doing this yesterday, but anytime you try to do a vlog, you should always make sure that all your batteries are charged and ready to go. And about halfway through, or not even halfway through, quarter way through, both my phone was dying and my Canon EOS M3 was dying. So I bagged it in for yesterday and I'm going to start fresh today. And speaking of the Canon EOS M3 that I use, I did a vlog earlier last year about upgrading to the M5 that Canon released in the fall. And at that time I wasn't going to upgrade because the features that I was gaining and what I used this one particularly for was not to my benefit, plus the cost factor in it was pretty high. So I did not upgrade, and then within the last couple weeks or so, Canon introduces their new EOS M6 now. They did a redesign of it, which eliminated the digital viewfinder on top of it, because it does not have the DSLR look, mini look anymore. It's back to the what mine looks like, the EOS M3. So they got rid of that, which helped drop the price down. So it's cheaper, a little more, a couple hundred dollars more than what the 5 was. So it's cheaper there, but they lost the digital finder. You'd have to do the optional one, which I do anyway. But all the specs and everything seem to be the same as far as what I've seen so far. So I probably won't be upgrading to the 6. I don't know why they did it so quickly. Usually the iterations of versions that Canon usually does is a year to 2 years, or if not more. But they just released a new one, or coming up in March, it's coming up. So I won't be doing that one either, but let's get started on this Magic Lantern and see what we can do. When we first bring up the menu here on the Magic Lantern, it has the exposure menu. We covered that one last time. It had the white balance, ISO, and everything. So we're going to move on over to the next one. That is the overlay menu. And from what I've been finding on it, there's a lot of nice features in it and kind of things that I'm still learning about, so we're not going to delve in it too much, just like we did with exposure. I'll come back to those later as I learn and use them more and more. But the first one is global draw, and you're going to have to enable that to get any of the features down below in the menu there. And you have a few options as far as when you can use those features. You can use it in live view, quick review, that's when after you take the picture, your picture flashes on your screen. And you have so many seconds, you can set it, you know, however long you want to see it to review the picture you took. Or you can have it on all modes. I'm going to leave it on all modes because I don't want to be going back and forth between them. So we're going to keep that on. And then our first one is zebras. And zebra stripes, they show your overexposed and underexposed areas. If we go into it and go over into the queue area here, it will give you the what you can use it as far as in the color spaces, your RGB, you got your LumaFast. I'm going to stick with RGB because I'm, like I said, I'm still learning some of those aspects and I don't want to get too confused with that. So we're going to go under exposure. You can set it as far as disabled or how much percent you can go. I'm going to go to the highest on that one. And overexpose, you can also set that to the percentage of how you want it to read to, or even disable it. I'm going to go to the highest one on that one. When recording, usually that's when you're showing it on movies. I'm going to hide it for now. You can either hide it or show it. And then use raw zebras. That's usually in live view and after you're taking a picture it will show. And then the zebra underexposure value. Evaluate your exposure levels that you want to show above the noise floor. And you can turn that on, off, or you can go through the different evaluations on that too. So we're going to go back into zebras and I'm going to take my quick picture with this. So here's a quick picture I took of just a plant that I have. All that white stuff is the underexposed area, I do believe. Like I said, I'm still learning this, but it's kind of a nice pattern to show how that plays up there. And once you hit your play button, that goes away. The next area that I'm going to cover here is on the focus peak. I think. So So we're going to go ahead and turn it on and hit the Q button so we can go into the menu here. You have your filter bias. That's the algorithm that it's going to choose to detect. You can do balanced, fine details, or strong edges. I'm going to do the strong edges on this one. Image buffer, I'm going to set it as low res. And display type, blinking dots. But you can also do fine dots, alpha blend, sharpness, or raw. So I'm going to do the blinking dots on that one. And the threshold is 2%, and you can go, I'm going to go up to 5%. I was at 2%. And then the color, that's the focus peaking color, or fixed color coding, as it will show. I'm just going to do a global focus on this one. You can do all the red, green, blue, cyan, and magenta. But like, I'm still playing around with this. I'm going to leave grayscale off because that makes your picture just gray looking. And so that's the settings on focus peak. I got it's on. It's at the 5% and global. So let's go take a picture. And there we go on the focus peaking. Everything that's highlighted in blue there. I think I can. Nope. I can zoom in. But it's not going to do any difference. Zoom out. Zoom out. Yeah. So all that blue peaking is the focus peak. All those blue dots that you see on there. And they're not blinking like it should be. So let's go back into there and do another different. Let's go in and do a different bias on this one here. We'll do fine details this time. High res. That's your two options. High res and low res on image buffer. And blinking dots, let's do the alpha blend this time. I'm going to leave it at 5% and go back to Q, take a quick picture. And now we got in red everything that is focused peaking or evaluated as focused peaking according to their algorithm. And it seems to be, I'm going to try to go over to this far right leaf here. Yeah. See, it seems to be the sharpest in that picture there. So that's basically what's that doing. Let's go on into our next Magic Zoom. I really like this one. We'll turn focus peaking off for now. The next feature is the Magic Zoom. Now in the Magic Zoom, going to go ahead and turn that on and go into Q so we can set it up. On the trigger mode, you can have it set to where you zoom in to record, zoom focus, the focus ring, the manual focus ring, or if you zoom in on the little spyglass there, or always on. So I'm going to leave it on always on, and this only works in the live view. So the size of the what you want to show as far as the zoom part, I'm going to go with a medium. I'll show you that. Position, top left, magnification, 2:1. Let's try 3:1 this time. And focus confirm, you can do split green bars, split screen, or the zero cross, SS zero cross. Let's do the green bars on that one. Go back out to Q, that's on. And we gotta go into, so as you can see in the little magnification window there, It's set at the 3.1 zoom, and it can tell that I'm pretty sharp on that object right there. Take a photo of it, and there you have the photo for the magnification zoom. Now if we go into, out of there, oops, didn't want to turn off. Go back, always on. That's my trigger that I'm going to use. I'm going to go back into the zoom in. I'm going to make it larger this time. I keep the position and I'm going to go down to 2:1 and confirm focus with, let's try the zero cross. I'm not quite sure what that is, so I think I know, but let's see. So I'm going to go ahead and focus on my guy, get it focused, do the zoom in button, and there you can see the SS cross. Kind of splitting his head. Probably not the most accurate thing, and probably a tripod would be better to do this with. But let's go ahead and take a photo. If I zoom in, it's pretty sharp for the distance that I'm doing on this. This is a 50 millimeter lens that's on here. So that's the Magic Zoom. You can play around with that. I've enjoyed kind of using that little Magic Zoom on there. The little video window that comes up, and it's kind of glitchy sometimes, so it does help out with the focus. So let's just turn that off and go down to crop marks. Turn that on. And basically what crop marks is just showing you the different cropping facility or formats that you can use on here. You got Cinescope, you got the Cross Master or Meter, and then Passport. And you can also show your own or create your own in Windows Paint, it says at the bottom there. You can draw your own crop marks in Paint, and I assume they mean Windows Paint. I'm going to leave it on this one, the Cross Master one. Show in photo mode and show in play mode. So you go back out of that. Let's take a photo. And I don't know if you can see the crop mark there. That's after taking a photo in photo mode. If I go into live view mode, it also shows up in there too. So that's just the different cross marks or cross mark overlays that you can use in the Magic Lantern. All right, so we've covered a few of the menus on Magic Lantern. So let's dig in next on the next one here, and that would be the ghost image. This one I found pretty interesting, and my camera's kind of getting funky now. But if we go ahead and turn that on and go into the Q button, the only option you have is to update the image of your overlay, and we're going to turn that on, go back to Q, and then go ahead and get out of there. Now this was the last picture I took right there, and that was the back of my little stand there. As you can see, it has like a ghosted image on top of what you're seeing in the background there. And the only thing I can see this would be functional for is if you were doing like a animation or whatever, stop motion animation. You can see the chair, edge of the chair there in the window there, kind of getting blurry and everything. So it's kind of interesting how, you see, it's auto updating too. So that's a ghost image. It gives you like a ghost image of your previous picture you took. And it also does a automatic updating. Let's see if it does that. Let's see if I did that one. And now that is my current ghost image. So it's kind of a funky feature. Like I said, you probably would use it for a stop animation or something along those lines. I'm going to be playing with it for a while and see what kind of functions I can get out of it. Because if you were to take another picture, it just replaces that one. But if you were to go ahead and play them back, I can see how you would be able to do an animation if you were to set it up properly like that. That's my dog at the end there. And so that's the ghost image as far as that. We're going to turn that back off. And then let's go on to Spot Meter. Turn that on. We go into the queue. It's getting funky now. And you got the Spot Meter unit. You can do it by percent. You can do it by color, the 0 to 255, which is white to black or black to white. The RGB HTML, the raw, and then the RGB percent. I haven't played with the spot meter too much, so we'll go with the RGB HTML. And the position of the spot meter, you can either do focus box or the center. And as far as mine, that's where they're both playing is right in the moment there. So that gives you your spot meter. And there you go, you got your color grading. It's a 2C201F, which is your RGB HTML. Let's go back into that. Let's not erase that. Let's go back into there and set a different type. Let's do percent this time for the spot meter, see what that gives us. Gonna go ahead and focus on that. Take a picture. And 13%. What do we do, percent? Yeah, so 13% evaluation of that spot meter. So it's a pretty cool feature. Like I said, I'm gonna be playing around with it some more. Let's go back into Magic Lantern. We'll turn spot meter off and we'll go into our next one here. Okay, so let's go into our next menu on here on the Magic Lantern, and that would be false color. So we're gonna go ahead and turn that on, go into the Cue menu there, and you get to about six choices there. You got the Marshall, small HD, 50 to 55, 67 to 72, banding detection, and color screen. And as you scroll down, you get the different palette that it shows underneath: banding detection, 67, 50, and small HD, and a Marshall. So I'm going to leave it at the Marshall there and go back out of there. I found a little website on red.com that goes over some of these features that I've been covering with Magic Lantern. So I'm going to give you that link down below. It covers false color, which is what I'm going to do right now, and then the Zebra tools and everything. So I leave that link in there. It goes over a lot of different things in here. So that will be kind of, if you're more interested in finding more aspects of that. So I'm going to leave that on there. But let's go back into here. So we have the false color on Marshall. Let me take a quick picture of my little stand over there. And as it does the review, you can see that different colorings are covering different values of the picture. And if you hit your review button on there, they go away and you can see what the original picture was. So let's go ahead out of that, go back into there, under false color. We're going to select green screen at the very bottom. I don't think that's going to give me much difference though. Because there's no green screen, so obviously it's not going to do anything for that one. Let's go out of that, go back into the menu, Cue. Let's try the 67 to 72 version. Go ahead, take that same photo. And then you have the banding, color banding on there, covering the false coloring. Like I said, I'm reading a little bit more up on this. I'll give you the link below to red.com, and they will go over it a little more thoroughly than I can, or right now I am. In the future, I'll be covering it a little bit more and more. But for now, that is your false color. So we'll turn that off. Our next avenue is the histogram. And most of those, your cameras have that on there right now anyway. You can do the raw database, pistol bar, the YUV based with the RGB dynamic range with the ETTR hint, and as usual down below, choose any evaluation image indicator to display on the histogram, show how many stops you can push, and then you got the logging, you got the linear or the logging, and then clip warning will display warning dots when one color channel is clipped. So that covers that. We'll leave that on. And we'll go out of that, and we'll go take our same picture, same boring picture, Jack Daniels and all that good guys over there. And down in the lower corner here, you can see that your overview of your histogram. But Canon comes with that already when you do the review. If you go into your info button, you can see the over and under exposure as far as there's your RGB histogram. So as far as the histograms, I believe Canon covers that a little bit nicer. You may have more options in this one, but for my purposes, as far as the histogram, I'll basically probably use the one that comes with the Canon camera. So let's move to the waveform. Now this one I was playing with yesterday, and it's kind of weird how this one. And I don't have too much information as far as the use of the waveform. I imagine it's for the exposure of underexposure and overexposure. But let's go with a large one as far as I selected yesterday. We'll go out, take a quick photo. And that is the waveform of it. It kind of looks like an alien, you know, kind of coming at you or whatever. That's all the features of the waveform. Like I said, it's kind of weird, and I'm not quite sure how to interpret it. I'm believing it's over and under exposure or white to black. But your white should be higher, so maybe black to white. So we're going to look into that a little bit more, and I will cover that in more in depth in a future one. And as we get down, let's turn off the waveform. The only other options you have on the waveform is large, small, and full screen. So, and I noticed on full screen, when I do that one, I'll just do a quick one. There's a photo, and then it's just the large screen, and you can't really see your photo anymore. So you just have the large waveform there. So that covers that one. And then vector scope, we'll turn that on, go into the queue. Either got UV scaling times 2 or off. So we're going to do times 2. And like I said below, the little thing shows color distribution as UV plot for grading and white balance. So let's go ahead and take that same photo. There's the review. And then there's the color grading. It gives you the little color scale. You got your magenta, yellow, blue, green, and all those as far as your pie chart on your photo. So that is your vector scope. It just shows the color distribution as far as that is your the picture you took on your photo. And then finally, probably the simplest one of all, has the on-off, no other options. You get your level indicator, and for that one, I'm going to go to live view mode. And if you can see that little green line in the center, it's just showing your level. And it does it in 0.5 increments. And up in the upper corner here, upper left corner, you can see the degrees. Let's see if I can get it to zero. Doesn't want to go quite to zero. So that's the coverage of the menus for overlay in Magic Lantern today. Like I said, I'm going to be covering them more in depth in the future as I get to the end of all the menus. Didn't just do the simple overview of all of them, and then I'll go back over each one. If you want a specific area covered or more in depth on each one, we'll drop it in the comments and let me know, and I will try to research it and get back to you on that. In the future vlog or even in the comments. So I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe and like if you did down below, and I will see you in the next version of the Magic Lantern, probably within a week or two at the most. This one went 3 weeks. I didn't want to go that far, but I had things that popped up last week and I couldn't get it out, and then yesterday all my batteries died. So this is it, and I hope you enjoyed it. Have a good day.